I came upon writing Half-Broke Horses really because of readers. I'd been kicking around for a while for somebody to write about, and I've been doing a lot of events where I talk to readers. And the question they kept asking me, more and more than any other question, was about Mom. People wanted to understand Mom. I love readers. I think they're really smart, and they ask good questions. And sometimes I knew the answers to their questions, and sometimes I didn't. But very often when I would tell them something, their faces would illuminate, and they'd say, oh, now I get it. Now I understand your mom. And a number of them said, your next book should be about your mother. The reason I wrote Half-Broke Horses in the first person is because I felt it gave an immediacy. I wanted to capture Lily's voice. Lily had a very distinct and powerful, a unique voice, and I wanted to capture her spirit. I did know my grandmother growing up. That was one of the ways I believe I was able to capture her voice. I have a very vivid memory of this tough, leathery, sort of yellow-skinned woman who just, she'd always pick me up. She always yelled. She never said anything. She just always yelled it. She sang. She danced. She shot guns. And I was always captivated by her. It was always this experience when I went to see my grandmother because she was so different from my mother. Even though they both were incredibly full of life, Lily Casey Smith, she'd play honky-tonk piano. I have a lot of vivid memories of Lily. And in fact, my mom is always telling me, you're just like my mother. And I think it's not always a compliment, but I'll take it as one. Some people who've read The Glass Castle like my mom and think that she's sort of a free spirit and unique character. Others said, I don't understand your mother. I don't understand why a woman with a college education would make the choices that she made. And this is one of the reasons that I love memoirs, I love biographies. I love finding out about what motivates people, because the answer's always there. You might not love the answer, but it's always there. And if you're willing to dig deeply enough, you can find it. And I hope that people come to understand not only my mother, but that this time and place in America, this sort of untamed part of America, Arizona in the 1930s and 40s. And I hope that in seeing this story of this tough lady who made it against all odds, she wasn't dealt the best hand in the world, but she played the bejesus out of that hand. And I hope that in addition to Half-Broke Horses illuminating something about my own family, I hope it informs them something about themselves. I hope that they recognize something about their own heritage in this.